You go. Come on out.
Right now at 5:30, America's most well-known prisoner is a free man. Find out where O.J. Simpson is headed and why that state isn't happy about it. Plus,
the pain that we got, sorry, I don't want to cry.
An emotional family pleading for answers after an 18-year-old was gunned down last month. What we know about that fatal shooting and what police need from you. And the Phoenix Fire Department is mourning the loss of one of their own tonight. Their chaplain, Father Carl Carlozzi, died today after a battle with cancer. But first, we're tracking some breaking news. A teenager drowned this afternoon at Bartlett Lake. The Maricopa County Sheriff's Office told us the 15-year-old was swimming with a friend when they got separated. The Sheriff's Office dive team found the teen just before 3:30 in about 15 feet of water. They say it appears to be a tragic accident. Our other top story tonight, the passing away of Phoenix Fire Chaplain Carl Carlozzi. Jeff Van Zandt joins us live with reaction to his passing. Jeff.
Yeah, Father Carl was battling cancer for the past year, and he passed away early this morning. Father Carl's career spans decades. He was not only providing spiritual aid to so many on the department, but so many in the community as well. He was involved in all of their lives. He baptized kids. He also took part in so many weddings. On top of that, he traveled to Ground Zero shortly after 9/11 to help in any way possible. He gave the last rites to the fallen Granite Mountain hotshots who died in the Yarnell fire. This is a man who will be sorely missed.
I know many who have been very touched by him coming alongside of them when they've had to, you know, do the unthinkable, such as bury one of their own family members, even a child. Father Carl was there to, you know, provide that emotional support, that reassurance, and that comfort through that dark time.
Now, he was the Phoenix Fire Department's only chaplain for the past 25 years, and when his funeral is has not been determined yet. Back to you.
Thank you, Jeff Van Zandt, reporting live tonight. An 18-year-old gunned down in a West Phoenix parking lot. It's an unsolved crime that happened less than a month ago, and right now, police are desperate to find leads. Here's Lena DeFlorius.
The pain that we got is, I can't even describe the pain that we got in my family right now.
Police know very little about the fatal shooting on September 9th. They know 18-year-old Damien was shot twice. They know he died in a parking lot near 67th Avenue in Osborne.
They found my son dead. And that day, our lives changed again.
His parents know their son died alone. They also know his killer is walking free.
We just want justice. We want justice.
The pain of losing his son is something the Navarro family has felt before. Their son, Cruz Antonio Navarro Jr., was killed 4 years ago, also at the age of 18.
They're good kids. I mean, I spent 18 beautiful kids with them, 18 beautiful years.
Police don't have much to go on. No suspect description, no vehicle to look out for. All they have is a grieving family pleading for help.
I like to ask whoever see anything, please help us.
Anyone with any information on this crime is asked to call Silent Witness at 480-WITNESS, and calls can be made anonymously. Lena DeFlorius for Arizona's Family.
And developing now, police are searching for a shooter after a man was killed at an Avondale bar. It happened in the parking lot at the Lighthouse Bar and Grill near El Mirage and Indian School Roads. A police officer was nearby when two groups got into a fight outside. Police say they don't have much information to go on.
When the officer was on scene, it was, you know, pretty hectic. There was a lot of things going on. You know, his concern was, you know, for the safety of all the patrons that were up here, as well as for himself and those responding.
Police believe the shooter left in a newer model burgundy Dodge Challenger. Gang activity hasn't been ruled out of this investigation. Another person was also hurt, but she's expected to be okay. An ASU student fell from a high-rise building and sadly did not survive. It happened yesterday morning. Maria Hechinova joins us with more on this developing story.
Tempe police have not released the ASU student's name, but that's not stopping others from paying their respects. You can see right outside of the W6 luxury apartment building, someone has left a balloon and two bouquets of flowers. Police say he fell from at least the 15th floor, but had not said if he lived here. Investigators say the student found dead is in his 20s and that it's possible he was drinking at the time. Students we talked to today are sad to hear what happened.
It hurts, you know, to hear that somebody young fell and died like that.
I've reached out to the management company for comment, but have yet to hear back. In Tempe, Maria Hachinova for Arizona's Family.
New tonight, we have an update on a story we brought you as breaking news last night. We now know the name of a man killed in a deadly motorcycle crash. We're told 40-year-old Brett Johnson hit a pickup truck that was making a U-turn near 7th Street and Mountain View. Police say Johnson was wearing a helmet at the time. They're now looking into whether the other driver should face charges. A Valley Road is back open tonight after a car lost control, hitting a fire hydrant and a power pole. This happened near 24th Street and Virginia this morning. We're told the driver wasn't seriously hurt. Phoenix police kept the road closed for a few hours while crews made repairs. New tonight, 3 weeks after Hurricane Irma ravaged the Caribbean and Florida, some businesses in the Keys officially reopened. They were set to reopen originally October 20th, but since so many of those places rely on tourism to survive, they decided to reopen early. Ashley DiMartino joining us live now to talk local weather and a little bit of a cool down, but then we're heating back up a little bit.
That we are. Not everybody is going to like the 7-day forecast for this next week. First week of October for us. And today, once again, temperature of 98 degrees for afternoon high. Outside right now, we're sitting at 95 degrees in downtown Phoenix. We've got clear skies out there. We'll see a few clouds coming and going tomorrow. The main story is going to be the very strong winds for northern Arizona. Here's what you can expect for the rest of your evening with those clear skies. 92 at 7 p.m., 89 at 8 p.m., and 85 degrees at 9 p.m. We'll take a look at that 7-day forecast coming up.
For the first time in nearly a decade, O.J. Simpson is a free man. He was released early this morning from a Nevada prison. Simpson was serving time for his 2008 conviction in Las Vegas of kidnapping, armed robbery, and 10 other charges. In July, the Nevada Parole Board of Commissioners unanimously voted to grant the 70-year-old parole.
Right now, I'm at a point in my life where all I want to do is spend time with my, as much time as I can with my children and my friends.
Simpson is starting his life outside prison in Las Vegas, but eventually will move to Florida, despite the attorney general not wanting him to return. She says his 2008 conviction, along with his guilty murder verdict in a civil case, are reasons enough to keep him out of Florida. Our Mike Wachus sat down with Fred Goldman to talk about OJ's release and how much he misses his son. Ron Goldman and Nicole Brown Simpson were killed in 1994. Simpson was acquitted of their murders. You can see our exclusive interview right now on azfamily.com. Still to come, nearly 2 weeks after Hurricane Maria devastated Puerto Rico, people are still in dire need. We'll tell you how many are still in the dark and lack drinking water.
Guns are not big and evil. They just, you know, people need to learn how to use them safely, and we need to have respect for them.
But first, after the break, a shooting range on wheels is here in Glendale. How they're empowering women to get involved in shooting sports.
Brought to you by More Furniture for Less. Great selection, guaranteed low prices, same day delivery.
You each drive a Ford pickup, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to show you a next-generation pickup.
Awesome. Let's do this.
The bed is made of high-strength steel, which is less susceptible to punctures than aluminum.
The stronger, the better.
And best of all, this new truck is actually... the current Chevy Silverado.
Current Chevy owners and lessees get a total value of $10,600 or 0% financing for 72 months on this Silverado All-Star. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
Whoa! Prices really must be falling at Express Flooring.
Call Express Flooring today for fast, free in-home shopping. Save 70% on all in-stock carpet, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl plank, including pet and stain-resistant flooring. Plus, Express will even move your furniture for free. Call Express Flooring today. Express Flooring is the best! Call 800-EXPRESS!
wherever you go, get there with the Ford Escape. The auto brand with the number one selling SUV lineup made the 2017 Escape smarter than ever, safer than ever, and more trusted than ever. That's how you become America's best-selling brand. Now get Escape with 0% financing for 60 months plus $1,000 cash back or $3,500 cash back. Only at your Desert Ford dealers.
Cirque du Soleil presents Crystal, where world-class ice skating and unexpected acrobatics fuse to create Cirque du Soleil's first on-ice experience. Feel the adrenaline as Cirque du Soleil creates a frozen playground and a world of wonder on ice. Cirque du Soleil Crystal, a breakthrough ice experience. From March 8 to 11 at Talking Stick Resort Arena. Tickets on sale at CirqueDuSoleil.com.
Oh, I switched to CenturyLink Internet. So awesome. There's no contract, and my price will never change.
Oh, they'll change it.
No, that's what I'm saying. Negotiation's over. Price won't change.
Yeah, it will.
No, it won't.
Yeah, it will.
No, it won't. Introducing CenturyLink Price for Life Internet. Plans start at $45 a month for speeds up to 20 megs. Keep your rate as long as you keep your plan. Switch now at CenturyLink.com.
Guns are important, and gun safety, you have to know what you're doing.
You may have noticed a mobile shooting range set up outside Cabela's in Glendale. They say their goal is to empower women in all shooting sports. The event is called Shoot Like a Girl. It's free. All the instructors are female and NRA certified. They teach women how to shoot a compound bow and arrow, as well as pistols and rifles.
We're all about shooting sports in general, and that could be for self-protection, and that can be protecting your family and your loved ones. That could also be going out to the range, having a friendly competition with friends. That could be going out into the field with your family and harvesting your food.
The Mobile Range also made a stop in Prescott this past week. After their stop in Glendale, they are headed to Arkansas and Alabama. A day after Secretary of State seemed to be open to talks with North Korea, President Trump publicly questions the move. What he tweeted coming up.
Brought to you by Nissan.
Halloween Time is back. Don't miss this spellibration. Now through October 31st with all new Halloween Time experiences at Disney California Adventure Park. Watch CBS 5's Wake Up Arizona from 6 to 7 a.m. for your chance to win a Disneyland Resort vacation.
Bob's Biker Blast is back Saturday, November 4th at Harley-Davidson of Scottsdale. Join us for incredible food, beer, biker babes, and live performances featuring Three Doors Down. Admission is free with a motorcycle endorsement. So visit hdscottsdale.com for details. All proceeds benefit Phoenix Children's Hospital, who loves you, baby.
My father-in-law, Pep Cooney, was full of life. He was a community leader and a devoted family man. Even after all these years, we still miss that smile. Hospice of the Valley helped him spend his last days at home with his wife, his children, and his grandchildren. He was given comfort and dignity, and we were given peace of mind. We wanted the most compassionate care. That's why we chose Hospice of the Valley.
Yeah, call this the cradle. You sleep like a baby.
When we saw that the mattress industry was broken, we didn't rest until we'd fixed it. We're Tuft and Needle.
Learn the truth at TN.com.
If you have good arch supports and your feet land the right way, you're taking good care of yourself. And that's what I wanted. These are my feet. They're worth it.
See for yourself with a free personalized arch support fitting at the Good Feet store.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Express Flooring. Call 1-800-EXPRESS.
They run toward danger instead of away from it.
You don't think twice about it. I just saw it as I was just doing my job.
A rare first-hand look at first responders risking their lives to save lives. Friday at 10, only on CBS 5.
President Trump took to Twitter today, appearing to cast doubt on the idea that diplomacy could resolve the crisis over North Korea's nuclear program. The president tweeted, "Being nice to Rocket Man hasn't worked in 25 years. Why would it work now? Clinton failed, Bush failed, and Obama failed. I won't fail." Last month, the president told the United Nations that Kim's regime was on a suicide mission.
"The United States has great strength and patience. But if it is forced to defend itself or its allies, we will have no choice but to totally destroy North Korea."
The State Department says the official U.S. policy on North Korea has not changed. A man is in custody after two suspected terror acts in Canada left five people hurt. The suspect first ran over and stabbed a police officer at a highway intersection in Edmonton last night. He got away on foot, but then led police on a chase in a U-Haul and deliberately hit four pedestrians. He later crashed and was arrested. No word yet on the condition of those pedestrians. The officer is expected to recover. Violence erupted in the streets of Barcelona after the Catalans vote on splitting from Spain. The country's national police launched a widespread crackdown on Catalonia's disputed independence referendum. Clashes between police and demonstrators erupted across the city. More than 800 people were hurt. Police in France also investigating a possible terror attack. Two women were stabbed and killed at a train station. Police say a French soldier then shot and killed the suspect. France has been in a state of emergency following a series of attacks over the last 2 years. Well, progress is being made in Puerto Rico, but the island is still in the middle of a major emergency. Right now, power plants work, but downed lines have 95% of the island in the dark. Half of Puerto Ricans also lack drinking water. FEMA says they've distributed $7 million in assistance to 63,000 Puerto Ricans. All right, time to talk about our local weather and what we experienced throughout the afternoon. Plenty of sunshine was out there for us. We started off nice and cool this morning at 69 degrees, and we warmed once again to 98 degrees this afternoon, 4 degrees above our average. Good news, though, nowhere near the record of 107 set back in 1980. So we've got this storm system. You can kind of really see how well-defined the center of the system is right here and how it's really pushing that jet stream further towards Arizona. That storm system is going to be slow moving towards the east. So as we head into the start of the week, it's going to push the jet stream right into northern Arizona, and it's going to bring in a little bit of a cooler air that's going to be moving in for us. It's also going to bring a lot of snow across Utah and Colorado as well. As you can see, we don't get any moisture here in Arizona and don't really get any cloud cover either. As we head through the day on Monday, though, those winds will pick up for northern Arizona, and temperatures will actually cool down by about 5 to 8 degrees across the state. But then as we head into Monday night and into Tuesday, we push that jet stream back up to the north. We start to bring in that warmer air coming up from the south, and we start a gradual warm up for the rest of the week. So with those strong winds of gusts around 55 miles an hour, the area you see here in khaki, that's a wind advisory that will be in place until 8 p.m. on Monday for northern Arizona due to those winds. For this evening, we're going to see a 48 in Winslow, 43 in Flagstaff, 58 Sedona, 53 for Payson, and 68 for Phoenix. Temperatures tomorrow, 93 for Phoenix, 73 for Sedona, 72 Payson, 70 tomorrow for Prescott, and 61 up in Flagstaff. Not too bad. As we head into Tuesday, as I said, that gradual warm-up comes into play. Temperatures staying above our seasonal average as we head through the rest of the week. And unfortunately, yes, Thursday, Friday, and even Saturday, we can be in the triple digits.